My name is Sebastian Kubicki. I'm from Germany, Thuringen. I'm now 39 years old. I'm going to be a chef around 20 years now. Chef is not easy, it's a hard job. Personally, for me, planning is important. So, in the German life, in Germany, we think preparing is always the best way. Otherwise, something happens, then what are you going to do? I'm always 15 to a half hour earlier somewhere, like today. I'm always come very earlier. I was really a German way, the things like this.
Sebastian, 今年39岁，来自德国图林根州的艾森纳赫市。现在是北京一家德国西餐厅的行政总厨。在中国工作13年，他一直在为顾客们烹饪最纯正的德国菜，同事们更喜欢叫他巴斯蒂。在餐厅其他员工眼中，守时是巴斯蒂最大的优点。每天上午，巴斯蒂都会提早半小时来到餐厅开始准备工作。
We have time. We have 24 hours a day, yes. So, not even 24 hours, because you get up in the morning 7 o'clock. You already have less time. So, you need to make your day right. So, this is how the job works. Because the thing is like, you have so much time to at work, so much time for your family, and you have to adjust the time. You have to plan a little bit. Not all completely how it looks like sometimes, but a little bit planning is important. Otherwise, the chaos break out, and this is something you don't like.Yeah, for example, in the morning, you have a morning routine. This means you start with this, you start with this, and start with the next thing, and then the day can go and start. This is a good start. You know, otherwise, oh, too late, already running, you forgot this one, and you start forget things. This is very bad, you know. So in the German life, in Germany, we think preparing is always the best way.
巴斯蒂从小生活在一个工人家庭中，父亲是本地汽车工厂的工人。母亲从事物业管理工作，每周末的家庭聚餐是童年的巴斯蒂最期待的仪式，这对于巴斯蒂来说是儿时最美好的风味记忆。
I like to watch people to cook something. That's true. Actually, my mother or my grandmother cook something. I like to watch always how they do something nice, and especially on weekends they make bigger food and this needs longer time. And you can smell it in your home. You can see the whole home smelling like.Oh, something very interesting is coming out today or tomorrow. The whole room, the whole apartment, or the whole apartment was smelling like this. It was nice, you know. You always have your own. Smell good. You get hungry already.
巴斯蒂的故乡德国图林根州的艾森纳赫市是一座德国中部的小城，也是德国著名音乐家巴赫的故乡。由于图林根州森林覆盖率很高，又被称为德国的绿色心脏，在图林根，香肠是他们最引以为傲的美食。
This one is the Thuringian style sausage. I call it style sausage because it's not made in Thuringia, it's made here. So you call it is a Thuringian style, a Thuringian sausage style, the style of Thuringian sausage. Yeah, it's a sausage with it's one of the famous sausages from Thuringian, also from Germany actually.It's a very sausage, a very important sausage, personally for me as well. The best way to enjoy the sausage from Germany is you grill it on the barbecue, and then you eat it in the bread. Make a mustard on it, and you eat it. This is the best way to eat it. Easy and fast, and you keep, don't need long time. You don't need to wait for long time for food. You don't like to wait for long time to eat.
香肠是德国菜最重要的组成部分。德国人的三餐都离不开香肠。在德国，香肠的种类就有1500多种，每个城市的做法都不尽相同。
We have a lot of varieties of German sausages, a lot. I mean, a lot of sausages, I have to say, have similarities in the same sausage, but inside the flavor sometimes is different. How to make them is different. We have a lot of forest parts. Some people have mountain parts.You just have to find a different kind of things to make sausage.
巴斯蒂做厨师以来，香肠绝对是他最熟悉的食材。 虽然德国的香肠种类千差万别，但最受欢迎的香肠做法非咖喱香肠莫属。能否做好咖喱香肠，是对于一个德餐主厨优秀与否的最佳评判标准。在制作咖喱香肠时，巴斯蒂首先将香肠用水焯烫，之后上锅煎熟，搭配加入大量咖喱粉的番茄酱汁，口味辛辣而浓郁。这道菜也是巴斯蒂心中德国味道的最佳代表。
Especially when you're growing up and you're a kid, you get used to one sausage very much, and you like this kind of sausage, andthis is something you never forget and always look for it, you know. Because even me, when I go home, for example, I visit Germany again, I know exactly what I'm going to do. I have a favorite sausage, I go for it first. The first dish I do, you know. Go for a twinning apart was with a bread. It's the first thing you have to eat.
德国位于欧洲的中部，从北部的波罗的海延伸至南部的阿尔卑斯山，是欧洲邻国最多的国家。周边国家不同的饮食文化，让德国各个州的口味都不尽相同。
Germany is around a lot of countries. This influence our food a lot. Yeah, go to the border from the southwest border, we have France. So this area is really influenced by French cuisine, yeah, French food. But you see the even French and the other neighbors are from Holland or from north, from Denmark or yeah, from Poland.Poland also a lot of foods mixed, you know, and from Czech, the Bohemian cuisine. So you can see when you go to a place like Bavaria, downstairs is the Austrian, yes. So you see the differences of the food also.
巴斯蒂从小就对烹饪很感兴趣。高中毕业之后，他考入了图林根一所烹饪学院，正式开始了他的美食之旅。然而在刚毕业时，他最希望成为的却并不是一位餐厅的主厨。
Actually, it's the other way around. I don't want to be a chef in the first place. I want to be a baker in the first place. And I also go first to a bakery and checked out how is it there. And this was really, I loved it. But the baker told me, Sebastian, you know, you have to get up early in the morning, around, you have to be ready 4 o'clock, you have to stay here or 3:30.In the morning, you have to start to bake stuff.
在德国，面包是一日三餐必不可少的主食。德国人对于面包的制作要求非常严格，必须考取面包师资格证才能开面包店。可是当巴斯蒂顺利成为了面包师之后，他觉得一成不变的烘焙生活并不适合自己。就在他犹豫不决的时候，一个长辈为他指明了方向。
Well, one of my best friends, his father's chef, was a head chef in a restaurant during this time. And I like to be always sometimes a guest there, to eat together with them in the evening. And see, oh, it's very good, you know. Should try this also sometimes.
在离开面包店之后，巴斯蒂正式成为了一名厨师，在德国和瑞士多家酒店的餐厅工作。21世纪初，随着互联网的普及，巴斯蒂结识了来自世界各地的朋友。当得知巴斯蒂是一名厨师后，一位中国网友的邀请让他第一次有了来中国看看的想法。
And I met him close there, and he was from Sichuan. And then he asked me, "Hey, you want to visit? You can visit my parents, and there will be no problems, okay?" So I decided to do this really, and I went to Sichuan. I actually had the first time my Chinese food was about hot pot actually with my friends. This was I couldn't taste my tongue anymore. This was very hard. The first time, it's a very shock for your body as well. Because the Germans have spicy, but it's not spicy like this spicy. And when you eat it first time, you say, oh, this is very different right now. Because you can, the breath is more heavy, and everything don't stop. It's continue, you know. But in the end, you get used to it, and you eat it quite every day. So I really like the flavors.
热辣的川菜让酷爱美食的巴斯蒂舍不得离开，哪怕是为了地道的美食，他也要留下来。2006年，巴斯蒂开始在西南财经大学学习汉语。毕业之后，他毫不犹豫地选择留在中国继续发展。
I didn't learn in Germany. I learned here, in this country. A lot of things I learned here. To be open, to be flexible, a lot of things in other way, to understand things sometimes, they are not always like this, you have to understand it differently sometimes. You learn a lot of things here, you know. The most important part I always mention to everybody is like, if you're a student or something, you want to come to China, it's a good idea actually, even for 1 year, because the rate of learning is so fast here, much faster than Europe. Because Europe is more like a sleeping bear, you know, sometimes you need some time to learn something. It's up to you also sometimes, but here you get pushed to learn. So you will learn here or die, something like this. But you learn here very fast. The rate of learning is incredible here. There's a reason.
2007年毕业之后，巴斯蒂陆续在成都和重庆的酒店担任西餐厅主厨。2014年，为了追求更广阔的发展空间，他决定去北京的西餐厅工作。通过朋友的介绍，巴斯蒂成为了现在这家德国餐厅的行政总厨。在工作中，向来严谨的巴斯蒂不放过每一个细节，厨房内外到处都能看到他的身影。对于每一道菜，巴斯蒂都始终坚持原汁原味的德国味道，不做出任何改变。
I don't want to fake it, you know, this is not good. Because even when you're in Germany, I'm sometimes disappointed about Chinese food because this is not how I know it. And I was living in China for a long time, I eat it here, and they make it differently there. I said, why you make it different here? Yeah, because they don't understand and don't know how to go with it. Because in Germany, you have always two parts, you know, you have for the German guy, the menu, and then maybe you go to a restaurant and they give you the Chinese menu. And a different menu is a different taste. You have the real taste, and I have the made up for Germany easy peasy taste, and more the welcoming taste that you get used to it.
巴斯蒂工作的餐厅拥有一大批老主顾，很多客人都是从餐厅开张时光顾，一直吃了20年。许多老客人甚至还能回忆起他们第一次在北京吃到正宗家乡味道时的场景，并且他们都会提到同一个名字。这家餐厅的创始人申德勒先生。上世纪80年代，餐厅的创始人申德勒先生长期生活在北京。1990年，他曾在北京的一家合资肉类加工企业担任公司经理。高速发展的中国市场让申德勒看到了全新的机遇和挑战。他放弃了回德国担任公司高管的机会，留在了北京。2003年，他在朝阳区开始了自己的第一家德国餐厅。今年正好是餐厅的第20个年头。2020年，由于疫情原因，已年近80的申德勒先生非常挂念远在德国的家人，不得已选择回到德国。在离开中国之前，申德勒把厨房的大小事务都交给了巴斯蒂负责。对于这份信任，身为主厨的巴斯蒂从未放松过对于自己的要求。工作的间隙，他给远在德国的申德勒先生拨通了电话，汇报最近的工作成果。
Hello, how are you? Good, good to see you. How's everything in Magdeburg?
Long time.
Yeah, a long time.
But you didn't change.
Thank you.
So myself, I'm sitting on my luggage and I wait since 2 years to go to China.
Yeah, it's very difficult now to come. The pandemic thing is really difficult. I want to show around a little bit a new restaurant in Wangjing. We opened this restaurant last year. I want to show around a little bit.
Yeah.
You see?
Wow.
Yeah, so...This one, also is a new one. It's the best of each restaurant you put in one restaurant.
Yeah.
厨房之外，餐厅的管理同样非常重要。申德勒先生把这项工作交给了和他搭档20年的经理余成双负责。
我叫余成双，黑龙江齐齐哈尔人，来北京23年了。刚开始，2003年开始的时候是外国人比较多，德国人为主，其他的因为我们毗邻使馆区，其他的国家的客人也很多， 反正主要是外国人占比应该是在70%左右，中国人能达到30%。08年之后呢，正好就反差过来了，中国人能达到70%多，外国人呢在30%左右。
余成双20出头就和申德勒经营着这家德国餐厅。20年前餐厅刚开张时，北京的客人明显对于德餐不太熟悉。
当时开业的时候正好赶上北京2003年非典，几乎是没有客人的，都是申德先生周围的一些朋友啊，3-5个呀，5-6个呀，每天晚上过来喝一杯啤酒啊，吃点东西，这种的情况。当时那个因为地理环境因素，我们前面就是雅宝路，有一些货站的老板啊，还有一些批发商什么的中国人，他们之前应该是接触过这些西餐，但是不完全能够确认他们接触过德餐，但是他们刚开始来到我们店的时候呢，比较能接受，因为德国的香肠啊、猪肘啊、啤酒毕竟是名气在外。
从最初开业至今，餐厅已经进入了第20个年头。最近几年的工作之中，巴斯蒂和余成双一样，也看到了顾客的很多变化。
The older customers mostly order the meats, you know, the meat plates and everything, the pork knuckles and the sausages and the meat. But you see, younger generation is looking for salad. the centerpiece is always a piece of meat for them, and around this center still have order some vegetable options. So you can see already, you see already they change also the say how they're eating something. So younger people already think about.I can't eat only this meat. Maybe something a little bit vegetable would be okay.
20年的时间，让这家起初只有10张桌子的小店，成为了北京小有名气的德国餐厅。可就像开业那年遇到了非典一样，20年后，身为主厨的巴斯蒂同样在为新冠疫情的冲击发愁。在今年3月的拍摄期间。北京虽然还没有停止餐厅的堂食，但客流量比疫情之前少了很多。客人少了，业绩自然也就少了。巴斯蒂作为整个厨房的主心骨，同时也是申德勒先生最信任的人之一，想的最多的就是如何能够让餐厅渡过难关。午休时间，巴斯蒂刚刚结束厨房的工作，来不及休息，就开始安排接下来的工作计划。现实的情况让向来不愿意做出改变的巴斯蒂也不得不寻找新的出路。
But of course, big parties is a no-go now. So you cannot have a big party, you cannot have a big function anymore, you cannot have outside a big event. These times are not suitable now for this kind of things. So now.The focus is on here in our restaurant to make our food, maintain our food, maintain our quality of our food. People can still here eat something and drink something, they are happy. This is the most important part, you know. This is also a time of learning. This is not only a part. Sometimes things like COVID is sometimes, the COVID crisis is sometimes also a good thing to learn something new or to learn something more. Like takeaways, a lot of Chinese people get used to takeaway, you know. So a lot of people take the bao, yeah, take away.So they call, I want to have this and this and this, to take away, okay? So we pack it for them and ready to go, you know?
来北京工作8年，巴斯蒂逐渐适应了快节奏的生活，每天的工作都安排得非常紧凑。可有一道菜却让雷厉风行的巴斯蒂必须放慢节奏，耐心等待。德国烤猪肘是巴斯蒂最引以为傲的餐厅招牌菜。这道菜从开始制作到最终出炉，一共要花费将近4个小时的时间。一整个猪肘先要经过调料和啤酒的腌制，再用低温慢烤2.5个小时，使肉质完全软化入味。经过40分钟的2次高温烘烤，猪肘内部多余的脂肪被去掉，搭配土豆泥和德式酸菜，吃起来表皮口感酥脆，肉质细腻软糯。对于巴斯蒂来说， 新鲜出炉的烤猪肘是德国菜中不能缺少的主菜。
I think efficient way to keep it moist and then also very delicious. If you have the pork knuckle in front of you, it's a huge piece of meat and you have the first try, it should be very delicious, you know. So otherwise, it looks not good. So there's a reason we do it this way, to keep the juicy in, to keep it juicy and moist, outside that it's crispy, and this is perfect for me. This is a reason for me personally as a chef. If you take your first bite of dish, doesn't matter which dish it is, it should be good. Otherwise, the dish is not good. Because if you take your first bite and you're disappointed, then the whole dish is ruined in a way, you know. Because these are always very important. Make it like this, the first bite should be really nice and delicious. Not like, oh, why is it so dry? Maybe not the whole piece is bad or the whole piece is dry, but in this moment, you feel bad. As a customer, you know. There's a reason. This should be always the first bite should be good. It's very important.
巴斯蒂工作的餐厅比邻使馆区，很多客人都来自附近的德资企业。在客人看来，能够在北京吃上一顿地道的家乡菜，是他们工作生活中最好的慰藉。拍摄当天恰好有一个德国企业的聚餐，巴斯蒂挑选的主菜是德国人过节时一定要吃的传统名菜——德国牛肉卷儿。
拍照了吗？
可以
拍。
用牛肉和培根切片儿，加入洋葱和酸黄瓜，搭配德国人喜爱的黄芥末酱，撒上盐和黑胡椒调味。烹饪前用牙签儿将所有食材固定成肉卷儿。下锅煎制后，加入红酒，配以酸菜和土豆泥一同食用。这道菜口味浓郁有层次，是德国人圣诞大餐不可缺少的一道主菜，也是这家德国餐厅最受欢迎的菜品之一。
Because especially you're in China, you will love far away from home, so you want something to remind you at home. So.It's most important for a lot of Germans to live a long time abroad and finally have something, oh, this is like my home, you know, my grandmother or my mother did it for me before. And this is, make me also very happy because this is actually the goal that I want. Because if here, I want to eat something that's remembering me at home, so I come here to eat some. For example, the beef roll is a typical home type dish. And when you're a kid, you start to eat it already, so there's a memory of a lot of things.
每天餐厅闭餐之后，巴斯蒂都会带着所有人将厨房从里到外打扫一遍，并且提前准备好第二天所需要的调味料。他认为这样有序的工作才能在最紧张的时候确保出餐的效率和品质，每一个细节他都不肯放过。这道流程对于严谨的巴斯蒂来说是一天工作的最后一个环节。下班后，忙碌了一天的巴斯蒂终于有时间喘口气。他习惯在餐厅里安静地坐一会儿，计划着明天所有的工作。来中国16年，巴斯蒂的计划在变，身边的环境、客人的口味也在变，但他对于心中德国味道的坚守和传承从未改变。巴斯蒂深知纯正的德国味道才是他和这家餐厅能够立足北京的根本。这位德国大厨也希望这种味道能够在北京一直传承下去，让更多的人都能品尝到最传统、最正宗、最地道的原味德餐。